Fisher here, and today I'll be showing you how to make a custom branding iron, just like the ones you see in front of me. So I posted a picture of this on Facebook yesterday, and a good friend of mine said, "Hey, would you mind making me one? I'd love to have one for my YouTube channel." I said, "Absolutely. I'll get right on it. I'll have it done tomorrow." So I'm going to show you how to go through step by step, how to make a material selection, cut the pieces, weld it up, and you can start branding your neighbor's cats right away. Okay, so the first step in brand design is obviously going to be understanding what you want to say, what it's going to look like, etc. So to begin, I have Canadian Air Gun Hunter, that's his YouTube channel name, and obviously that's way too long, so I decided we're going to go with CAGH, which would be a lot easier. Now, I could just do CAGH, as you see it like that, just, you know, maybe have a little square or something like that, and just have it say CAGH, and that'd be the brand. But I also decided, you know, let's get a little more creative and see if we can't fit it into a circle that makes it look more like a branding iron. Step two is to take these two configurations over to the scrap bin pile and see what we have available as far as materials, whether or not we can make something like this, or if we have to stick with a simpler design like this. We'll just take this random pile of pipes back to the table and see if it's going to work for us. Okay, so based on the rough drawing that I made earlier, we need something that's going to be roughly 3.5 inches, 3 inches, and 2 inches. Looks like that's 3.5, 3, and 2. Perfect. Okay, so next step is to cut these down to length, and we're going to base that length off of the width of this material, which is about 1 inch. This is 1/8. So for this particular project, since we're going to be basing the whole thing off of the width of this flat bar here, I want to make sure that my pipe cuts come out exactly the same length as this. So the best way to do that is to take our combination square, and we're going to set the length to match the flat. Lock it in. So now I can set it up against the pipe, give it a mark, and I know when I cut, I'm going to get the exact same length as that piece of flat bar. And I'll do the same thing on all my other pipes. Okay, so I got the pipe on my chop saw. You can see the mark I made right there. So I'm just going to go ahead and get it lined up so that this side of the mark is lined up with this side of the blade. Just like that. So now I know that this piece here is going to be the piece I'm going to use, and that should be exactly the same thickness as that flat bar. I'll go ahead and lock it down and get going. Now just repeat for the other two pipes. Okay, so we got our three pieces cut to length. Now we just need to take a flap sander and go around and clean up these sharp edges. Okay, so the next step is to go ahead and make my C. I'm going to start the C because in order to make the A and everything else fit, I need to make sure I have the C set up properly. So we're going to start with the big C, and I'm just going to basically eyeball where I think I should cut this pipe to create a C shape. And then I'm going to take that, and I'll go ahead and, with a square, I'll go ahead and draw a line here and a line here, and we'll get that trimmed off. The best way to make this cut here is going to be with a cutoff wheel on a grinder. Got a thin blade here, and it's going to just trim right through there. Now, if you are doing this indoors like I am, you want to make sure you have adequate protection and that there are no, you know, things like gas cans nearby or anything like that. Well, as you can see, everything's coming together really nicely. I got the C and the G already completed. All I gotta do now is cut the flat bar for the A and the H. Okay, so we finally get to the fun part. We're gonna weld it up. I'm gonna start with the G. I'm gonna just put a couple tack welds right here. I'm not gonna weld the whole thing. There's really no point in that because it's all gonna get welded together in the end anyway. So watch your eyes. Okay, so I finished welding up all the letters, and the next step is to actually weld it all together. And to do that, I'm just gonna take some of this rod right here and I'm gonna weld it across in a couple spots just to make sure it all stays together. And it'll be one unit, and then we can weld a piece of pipe or something on it as a handle. Okay, well, I went ahead and skipped to the end. There was a lot of boring stuff in there that wasn't necessary to put in the video. So anyway, here's the finished product. I think it came out really nice. Now, one thing I did differently that I would normally not do here is, because I have to ship this thing to him, to make it easier, instead of having this 3 foot long rod here, this handle, I just created this little collar with some set screws in there so I can just take the, undo the set screws and just remove the handle. Of course, it's still hot right now, so I can't touch it. Anyway, you get the idea. Comes off, I can ship that to him in Canada, and I think he's gonna really like that. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure you like, share, and favorite this video. And please go check out Canadian Airgun Hunter. I'm gonna put a link to his channel right here. Give him a sub, let him know I sent you, and I'll see you guys next time.
Are you gonna shoot that?